Hey traders, this is Blake Morrow with Forex Analytix, and you're listening to the week ahead video for October 3rd, 2021. You guys and gals are in for a really big treat. We have Grega Horvat today, our Elliottician in the Forex Analytix platform. He's going to spend his time today talking about the setups in the market heading into this next week. But before we get into that, we have to talk about the seasonal offer. You know, every year around this time, as soon as summer's over, we offer a discount for traders. That first couple of weeks is all the traders are back in front of their computers. We want to make sure we extend that offer to you. Buy 1 month, get 1 month free. You can get 6 months for the price of four, or you get 12 months for the price of seven. It's a huge discount if for those of you that are into annual subscriptions. You know, so if you've been on the fence, you've taken a trial of Forex Analytix, but you've been waiting for that good price, well, you got it right now, and it's only going to last for the next week or so. So make sure you take advantage of it. Also, I wanted to mention to you before I turn you over to Grega Horvat, if you like these videos, make sure you give us a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel down below, and also jump on tradersummit.net. This has some of the greatest analysis from some really awesome market participants, economists, traders, analysts. You can read all their stuff every day. Tradersummit.net. Check it out. And without further ado, I'm going to turn you over to Grega Horvat. Have a great week of trading. I'll see you on Monday on the FACE webinar.
Hello traders, hello everyone, my name is Grega Horvat and welcome to our new week ahead video analysis in which I will look at the markets from an Elliott wave perspective. But before we go to the charts, I really want to bring attention to the new season offer for Forex Analytix. So if you love technical analysis, if you love macro fundamentals and basic technical analysis or Elliott waves in particular, then check those offerings on ForexAnalytix.com. Now let's dig into the charts. Now looking at stocks first, as you know, we have seen a risk off sentiment over the last week or so, and the reason was probably due to tapering. Interest rates were higher, so looks like that this has an impact on stocks, especially technology sector, and then you have this debt ceiling as well. Probably this will be lifted in final moments, like usually on October 18 is deadline, I believe. So of course this weighted on stocks, which are now in a corrective retracement, I believe. So we are only temporary moving south here on the S&P 500 first. You can see that market actually came to the downside below this trend line support. So in my opinion, we can be now in a wave four, because if that was wave three, where you have these very nice five waves up, well, this broken trend line of wave three channel suggests that market stepped into a corrective mode. Now, usually corrective wave four can retrace for 38.2% of an extended wave three. You will also see in a lot of cases where wave four will be very similar in distance compared to wave two. This also comes in here around 4,000. And then you have this wave four swing high of a lower degree, okay? So usually wave four can retrace back into the area of a former wave four. So here we have wave four of two lesser degrees, and here we have the swing high of wave four of one lesser degree. Why I'm highlighting the swing high rather than a swing low? Well, because when you have this fifth wave extended, like in our case, okay, red wave 5 was extended compared to wave 3 or wave 1, well, usually in this situation you will see price retracement of a higher degree wave 4 back into the starting point or the highest point of a wave 4 rather than ending or termination point of this wave 4. So all in all, this around 4,000 appears to be very nice psychological level. However, sometimes fourth wave, because they are corrective waves, can be very tricky and not so easy to identify the support levels, especially if price is moving to the right rather than to the downside. Okay, like a simple correction, you have an ABC moving south. But if there is a flat formation or a complex correction, well, maybe this pullback will not be so dip in price, but rather longer in time. So overall, I think that we are here in a corrective phase and that market will at some point again attract the new buyers and see more upside. And as I said, maybe this will be after October 18 deadline for debt ceiling. Now let's take a look also on German DAX here. Now, German DAX very clearly in uptrend here. I'm looking at a monthly primary chart where we are now sitting at this trend line here, parallel trend line of this bullish channel. So I think that there is a chance for more upside here into wave 5. Keep in mind that wave 5 should be made by 5 subways, right? So here I am observing now wave 4 correction. It's a contra trend movement that is also approaching some very nice supports already here. Around 14,800 is ideal support zone, so obviously still possible to see this tested, but overall just keep in mind that this is an overlapping drop here, so in my opinion it's a contra trend movement. So I will remain bullish here on German DAX. No reason to fight this trend. We have higher highs, higher swing lows, meaning that this is an uptrend in progress, and when you have this consolidation, I think it's very good idea, actually much better to just stick with the trend and look for potential opportunities on the long side rather than trying to call the multi-year top here. Now let's take a look also on euro dollar. So on euro dollar we are actually seeing some weakness coming in. Of course, that seems to be very obvious and normal because US dollar was already higher due to tapering speculations before stocks came to the downside. And now when we are seeing stocks accelerating into this risk-off mode in the last week or so, of course, US dollar is seeing even stronger here. So I'm observing still two interpretations. The first one shows the idea that we are here in a triangle, still in the middle of this process. You are now in a wave. This is a wave E bounce yet to come. Or maybe this rise from 2016 lows will still extend above these 2018 highs. Okay, so in either case, I think that there can be some support in the near future. Now looking at those two interpretations on a daily charts here, as I said, maybe we are here in a wave D of a triangle. I know it's a bearish wave count, but still this wave E rise is missing. So the first support is here at this 2020 March highs, okay, around 1.15 level, and then you have another support at 61.8% here at this swing low from 2020 June lows. Okay, so overall, I think that even if we are bearish here and will expect more weakness while the market is trading below these 2021 highs, I think that there will be rally coming here, minimum in 3 waves. Now, this rally could be interesting even more if we consider that we have another wave count where we are showing a drop in 3 waves as a wave 4 from 2021 highs. And again, much more important support is the higher one here than at 50%, meaning 1.15 level is a key level for this wave count. So we really have to see a reversal here for this wave count to still be valid and come in play. Okay, so for now we just have to observe the price action on euro dollar, and if we see really bouncing price, I think that we will try to call our higher degree rally for at least 3 wave movement. Now let's take a look on cable. Now cable came to the downside after this gas panic in UK, so this obviously impacted the currency as well. And what we are seeing here is actually price coming down back into this 2019 and 2020 highs. So obviously this was very important in the past, so I think that we have to pay attention to these price levels here around 1.35 now as well. It's also the 38.2%, very nice FIB level when considered that this can be a wave 4 pullback against the previous extended wave 3. So very important supports may not be far away. Also, let me mention that on the 4-hour chart, we are seeing this drop coming out from a potential triangle, meaning that this support may not be far away. Well, ideal support projection based on a triangle measurement is around 1.3340, where this distance equals to this wave A. Okay, so I measured, I took the distance of wave A and measured it from end of a wave E or end of a triangle. Now let's take a look also on Aussie dollar. Now Aussie dollar, I've been talking a lot about the Aussie dollar recently, and I still think it's very interesting currency that could bring some attention, especially to the bullish price action. I know that we have seen a very nice and deep pullback, but that's when everyone are trying to become even more bearish. Well, for me, it's time to just to be aware of where the higher degree trend is. Keep in mind that on a daily chart, weekly chart, we broke last year out of this multi-year downtrend. So I think that more upside will come after a pullback. So this pullback so far is very healthy, very deep one, but I'm not really convinced that it's completed yet. Why? Because we haven't seen an overlap with this bullish level yet with 75.23. Now, for those who are familiar with the Elliott Wave principle, you know that this overlap usually confirms that the previous drop was corrective. Because if you're tracking an impulse, okay, this overlap is not allowed, and that's a bear trend then. But if we get this overlap, then I think we could turn bullish. But what is interesting that even if we have these five waves down here in progress, while the market is trading below this bullish level, there will still be a turnaround in price, because after every five waves, market recovers. Keep in mind that we are also moving very close to this 0.7 psychological support, and then you have these lockdowns that will be removed, if I'm not mistaken, now in October. And if we compare the price action to the last year, you can actually see that last year there was a September, that there was a top in September, then a pullback, and when lockdowns were removed, we were seeing a very nice recovery here on Aussie. So again, now 2021, we have seen a top in September. Now we are pulling back, and I assume that we could see price stabilization in the next few weeks or months. So ideally, by the end of the year, we will see this reversal already forming and in full progress. Okay, so this analysis is more time sensitive rather than price sensitive. Okay, so I think that sooner or later we will see a recovery here. Also, China is a big deal here as well. And I think that, again, we have to look back and remind ourselves what the Hang Seng Index is doing on a higher degree scale. And what we are seeing here actually is correlation between Hang Seng Index and Aussie. You can actually see that we are here making a very deep pullback here on Hang Seng Index, and this pullback is now approaching the end of the cycles where market bottomed after 40 or 50 weeks of retracement. This has been the case here back in 2007, 2011, 2015, 2018, 2019 through 2020, and now again very similar here. So maybe we're in a late stages. Keep in mind that Hang Seng Index also have some very nice this trend line support connected from 2008 levels. So in fact, this could be moving, this drop could be in some late stages of this bear cycle. So if we are going to see a reversal to the upside, then like each time before, we can expect that Aussie will recover as well, which is in blue, okay, line in blue. So I think that this should be on our radar screen as well. Now, let's take a look also on, we have dollar Swiss franc. Now, dollar Swiss franc here is trying to make higher prices, probably due to lower metals. However, we are seeing the pair at 78.6% FIB level. Also on the 4-hour chart, there's potential wedge formation going on in wave C. So I think that this could be quite interesting if we can see more weakness here beneath 09214 level. And at the same time, if metals will hold support, keep in mind that metals turned very nicely to the upside at the end of last week, then I think that Swiss franc could be again moving to the upside. Also, I have Euro Swiss here. Very quick look, you can see that rise from that 2020 lows was in free wave, so I think that more weakness here can be in the cards as well. Now let's take a look also on dollar yen. Now dollar yen has seen a very nice break out of a triangle last week, and probably due to the higher rates and stocks were also moving to the upside at some point. So that was a key scenario for dollar yen to breaking out, okay? Because higher rates means stronger currency, stronger US dollar, then you have Japanese yen on the other hand when it's pressured to the downside, when we are seeing stocks holding a support. And also keep in mind that Bank of Japan is staying on hold with their policy, so obviously this makes a very nice breakout on dollar yen. However, from an Elliott wave perspective, again, we are coming out of a triangle. Triangle occurs prior to the final move within a higher degree trend. So I'm thinking that maybe this is a fifth wave trying to now already put in a high here. We also moved close to February 2020 resistance. So again, very important levels has been met up there, and that's why we can maybe drive prices a little lower here. Now, I'm looking at the 4-hour chart, very nice break out of this upward channel. This is very sharp drop. I believe this is only one leg. So you are waiting now on a pullback, and then at least third leg to the downside could occur here, maybe even taking us, bringing us back into this triangle range. Okay, so dollar yen, I think that for now could be limited on the upside. But if somehow we manage to recover above this 112 level, then I think that much, much more upside is going to be seen. Now let's take a look also on gold. Now gold here, monthly picture, same thing, we are just keep consolidating. So longer is the pose and more price is moving to the right rather than to the downside or to the upside, more stronger will be the breakout when it occurs. Okay, in my opinion, this can occur to the upside, because keep in mind that this after all was and still is an uptrend on a higher degree scale. So looking at the daily chart, actually we are observing two interpretations. The first one is that this is a triangle ABCDE, and we are now trying to form a base here at the lower side of the range and could continue higher to the upper side of the range. I'm expecting a retest of this upper trend line. Why? Because on the 4-hour time frame, we have seen recently a deep pullback, but an overlapping structure. And now you can see here that we are testing this upper trend line. So if we can break this trend line, which may happen next week, I think that more upside will be seen here. Maybe just temporary for a free wave rise, but still we could maybe rally towards 1800 while the market is trading above these recent swing lows. Okay, if somehow we fail to see any aggressive bullish impulses here on the intraday time frames, then maybe it's still very important to keep an eye on this second wave count, where pullback from those 2020 highs, August highs, can be deeper in price rather than longer in time. Okay, but even this one will still be seen as a wave four here, which I highlighted on a monthly chart. Now let's take a look also on silver. Now silver here is, I think, at very important levels. Here we have this basic technical analysis. It was a major breakout last year here, okay? Then you recovered very sharply above that level, and now we are just trying to consolidate, okay, and retesting this level. So I think it's a very attractive support which can call some buyers here. Also, I believe that position sentiment is at extremes here, so it's worth to keep an eye on potential rallies. Also, from an Elliott wave perspective, what I'm looking at here is a very nice 5-wave recovery here from 2020 lows. And then you have this very massive correction going on. And I'm looking this to be a flat correction where you have this 3-wave drop for a wave A, a corrective recovery here for a wave B, and now wave C underway towards the lower side of this range. What is very important regarding the personality here of these flat corrections is that you see just a temporary rise to new extreme highs or extreme lows. So this has been the case here for a wave B, and this has also or can be the case here now for a wave C. So I'm expecting something similar here now, a reversal to the upside after just temporary break lower. Also, let's compare the current price action, the wedge that I'm tracking, to the previous smaller wedge that occurred here at the start of the year. Notice that, if I try to hide this a little bit, now notice that here we have this wedge going on. Okay, then market came to the downside, it spiked below these levels just for a short period of time. It found a support, the price found a support at the lower trend line, and then price recovered out of this wedge pattern. And this is the ideal setup for recovery. So now again, when looking at the higher degree scale here, we have a wedge pattern. We tested the lower side and we spiked the previous lows here. Okay, so this formation, this price action equals to this one on the lower time frames. Okay, so I am looking for maybe to form something similar here. If we can break this trend line, okay, I think that there will be massive recovery coming here on silver. We also have some very nice reversal already going on here on the 4-hour chart, where I can count 5 waves up from the low. So at least in the short term, I think that we are set up, we have a setup for higher prices. Now let's take a look on crude oil. Now crude oil came back to the highs. What is important to note is that we are here now testing this high from 2018. You have this high 2021, of course. So it's question if maybe we are going to slow down here and make a correction ABC formation, or we are going to see slightly higher prices and we are going to see a top for a wave 5 a little bit later. So in either case, I think that when we are approaching the end of the year, I think that these gains could potentially slow down. We have also massive divergence here on the RSI as well. So we'll see how this plays out. I think it's a very tricky zone up here. Also, I've been looking at this head and shoulders formation for a while. We have moved close to these targets here. So maybe in the short term can be room for rally towards 78, then you have $80 per barrel. But overall, I think that this recovery could slow down in weeks ahead. Okay, now let's take a look also on some of the crosses. Now, quick look at the euro pound here. Euro pound, I will just look at the daily chart. Looks like it's ongoing downtrend that can resume after this formation is completed. I see a very choppy price action. So probably wave 4 triangle is going on here, meaning that be aware of a break to the downside towards the lower side of the range after ABCDE subway. So I think that this one can be quite interesting when we are going to see this wave E rally, because euro pound is very choppy, very sideways, so not a lot of traders, investors are paying attention to this currency at the currency pair at the moment. So I think that can be quite interesting once we will have this ABCDE legs in place, because that's when we can expect a breakout. Okay, so this can be our edge compared to others. Now let's take a look also on euro Aussie. Now, Euro-Aussie here is coming to the downside, and I think that more weakness is coming. We've been highlighting this trend line resistance that was retested from the outside of this channel. So I think that more weakness here could be coming, and this could be even more interesting if we are going to see stocks recovering, let's say next week or in the next 2 weeks, if supports will be seen, and even if we are just going to see sideways price action on stocks rather than any significant rise or drop. I think that as long as we are holding some supports on stocks, Euro ASI could see more weakness here. Also, if we look at pound versus kiwi, here this one is also interesting. Now on a weekly chart, you can see that we broke this trend line, we retested it from the other side, and now you have this daily chart also forming a breakout, and now in a bearish flag formation. Okay, so that was a breakdown here, and you have this bearish flag formation. So in my opinion, we could see more weakness here after this trend line is broken. Watch out for more weakness. Okay, traders, thank you very much for your attention. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will definitely keep you updated in member sections in the next week. Bye.